Now I'd just like to show you a comparison of the transmission line equations that you've seen in the past. When we did the transmission line section, one of the things that we did was we analyzed the wave equation for the current and the voltage. We didn't really use these to solve any of our equations, but we certainly were able to convert the simple telegrapher's equations to these second-order differential wave equations. Notice the similarity here. The electric field is also represented by the voltage. In fact, you know about this already. You know that the voltage is equal to the integral of E dot dl. So it's not surprising that we should have a similar equation for the electric field and the voltage. Another equation that we have is that the magnetic field is closely related to current. We know about this also, that the magnetic field is the integral of, the current is the integral of the magnetic field around a closed loop. So here we have two equations that represent very similar things. Let's take a look at this term right here. This term is the second derivative of the either current or voltage in the z direction. The Laplacian operator is d by dx squared plus d by dy squared plus d by dz squared. In the case of a transmission line, where we had done a simple transmission line in the z direction, the change in the x direction is 0 and the change in the y direction is 0, so this term right here would simply be the second derivative in z. The third similarity is that we have the complex propagation coefficient in both cases. Gamma is alpha plus j beta, regardless of if we're discussing electric fields or if we're discussing voltages or currents. The biggest difference is that electric and magnetic fields are vectors, and currents and voltages are not. The single biggest difference between simple transmission line equations and the free space propagation coefficients is that these terms are not vectors, they are scalars, and these two are vectors.